Hey y'all, welcome to the studio. Today we're going to talk about OBSBOT Meet 2 webcam, which has a lot of features, a 4K webcam which you are watching me through it right now. Let's get into it. Inside the box we have a user manual, the camera, a magnetic mount, a type C cable, a magnetic cover and a type C to type A converter. This is by far the smallest webcam I've ever seen with such quality. It's around 41 to 42 grams and comes in 3 colors. The front looks very minimal with the O logo. We have an LED indicator, 2 mics and the type C port behind the webcam. The magnetic mount makes it very easy to rotate the camera in any orientation or use it in portrait mode. You can simply stick the lens cover behind the magnetic mount to not lose it. There is also a standard thread which makes it easy to use with tripods and monopods. Have you ever heard bigger is better? You know what is the most important factor when it comes to webcam quality? It's the sensor size and the model. Have a look at this hole. If you try to pass the light through it, as you can see, because it's small, less light will go through, and therefore we can see fewer details, especially in dark conditions. Now if I make this hole bigger, more light can go through and I can see better. Let me explain it as if you are a 5-year-old kid. Sensor is like your room and megapixel is like tiles. The bigger the room, the more stuff you can put in it. The more details you can capture. Megapixel is like the tiles. No matter if you add many tiles, if the room is not big enough. The sensor used in Meet 2 is 1/2 inch, which is pretty much bigger than any sensors out there. And it also uses an aperture of f1.8, which lets more light go through, like that hole I showed you, and also gives you more blur in the background when you are focusing on something which is near the camera. Depth of field. Here's a quick quality test in SDR between different lighting, such as typical lighting, and now I turn off multiple lights, and as you can see, the quality is still good. I also want to increase the ISO so you can see how much noise it can get in very low light situations. This webcam supports multiple resolutions and frame rates such as 4K 30fps or 1080p 60fps for various usage. Here's an example of a 30fps versus 60fps video. And as you can see, in 60fps mode, motion is smoother. The color accuracy is very good, even if I set white balance to auto, and you can see that greenish look on my face is so low. It's not a problem. But of course, if you know how to manually adjust it, this is what you get. The autofocus is very quick, and as you can see, it quickly switches between close and far objects. The least distance it can focus is around 10 cm, which is great. Even for dark objects in the dark background, the Meet 2 does a great job at quickly changing the focus. Of course, it looks smoother when you get closer to the webcam, and when you go far, it may need to refocus, but it does a pretty good job. The frame rate is very stable based on 5 tests I made, and even this video I'm recording with the same webcam, and there are no problems such as stutters or anything else. I haven't tested 60fps for a long time, so I may update my review after a while with 60fps. In long-term use. For now, it works perfect. The microphone performance is average. It might be fine if you have an isolated room, and there are multiple noise reduction methods. This is how I sound from here with noise reduction off. This is how I sound with noise reduction weak. This is how I sound with noise reduction set to medium. This is a strong noise reduction mode. I'm also gonna talk while I have noise around me. Alright, this is how I sound. It's not gonna replace your microphone, but it's good enough for video calls and stuff like that. If you are close enough, it's gonna give you an average quality. It has some other features and we'll talk about them later in the app test. The one thing I love about this webcam is the automatic picture rotation. You don't need to make any software changes, no matter which orientation, it just gets the job done. Now it's time to go much deeper. Things get very interesting here. We're gonna talk about AI beauty filters, extra adjustments, auto framing, HDR, bokeh and manual settings. The official app is named OBSBOT Center. It's available for both Windows and Mac. The installation is easy and the interface is easy to use. First, we have the settings. Here you can change the resolution and you can set it to 4K. More resolutions and frame rates are available if you set up this webcam in OBS. For example, you can get a 24 FPS cinematic output. That's what I've been using so far for this video, which makes me look more professional. The reason most webcams don't look like a DSLR camera or cinematic is because they are limited to 30 and 60 FPS, but this one has a lot of options. Any camera changes you make inside the OBSBOT Center applies to other apps using the webcam. The settings can be saved on the camera and you don't need to set it up every time. The field of view is around 79 degrees, which is okay in my opinion. It's like I'm using a 16 to 18 millimeters lens on my camera. We have three options in the app: wide, which is the highest field of view, medium, which looks like this, and narrow, which has the lowest field of view. However, you can manually zoom up to 4x and change the position within app view and gimbal. We also have auto framing, which uses AI. For example, in close-up mode, it gets closer to me and it has automatic tracking. So if I move, for example, if I move here, you can see it's following me and it's pretty good at doing this. I'm becoming a part of the darkness. You can also choose upper body, which shows more of your body in the picture. It zooms back a little bit. And thanks to this feature, now I can show you my biceps. The group mode, which will automatically expand the area if someone joins you in the picture. Thank you, you can leave now. Works great. We also have automatic brightness, which automatically changes the brightness based on the situation. For example, if I turn off my lights now, you can still see me. Now, if I turn them on, you can see it slowly decreases the exposure. We have anti-flicker. If you have a light that is flickering in the background, like this one with black lines on the screen, choose anti-flicker on 50 Hz in my case, and you can see it's gone. We have automatic white balance, which makes your skin look more natural. I did use multiple colors and lights in the setup to see if it can do the job, and it can. However, I'm a pro and I'd rather set it manually based on the light temperature I have on my setup. If you see any greenish like this in your skin tone, you can simply fix that by reducing this hue. Go under 50 and it will fix the problem. As you can see, if you see magenta like this, now again it is a problem. You can increase it to a value above 50. The default value is 50, but I found it to be very good for me on value 48 or 46. We have contrast, which can make the image look more pop, you see. It makes dark areas darker and bright areas brighter. But because my setup already has a very high contrast, I'm gonna put it on 0 so I can get a better picture and more room to play with values later. You can change saturation. I like it on a value between 45 to 50. And if I need more saturation later, I can increase it in the editing software. I found value 45 or to 47 the best. It looks very natural and can compete with my DSLR camera. Sharpness is something that you should be careful about. It can make things sharper, but you see, if you increase it too much, things get a little noisy and they are not very natural. I'd rather use it, keep it on 0, but you can increase it a little bit if things are not sharp enough in your picture. We have an option for HDR. It doesn't mean the video is going to be recorded on HDR, but once I turn it on, it can give me more steps between the bright and dark areas, so there are more details in both shadows and highlights. So here I'm gonna show you a before and after. This is how I look on SDR, but at the same time, on the right side of the screen, you can see how I look on HDR. In the microphone settings, we have radio distance, which asks you how far you are from the camera. This is how I sound when set to close. This is how I sound when set to standard. This is how I sound when set to far. You may wonder what automatic gain control does. It makes the audio louder or quieter based on how loud you speak.
So for example, I'm speaking should increase the volume, and now I'm speaking very loud and it should reduce the volume.
Even though the software itself has multiple options for recording videos, I'd highly suggest learning OBS and recording from there. That's more reliable. We have the bokeh effect. With native you get less blur, and it's not very accurate. It works fine if you don't have a busy background. But with advanced mode, as you can see, it uses an advanced method which looks even better and it's much more accurate. All this beauty and extra options only work when using it within the OBSBOT virtual camera. You can opt out the picture to OBS as a virtual camera or any other software. But these are effects and not the camera settings. That's why if you want to use them, you have to use the main OBSBOT Center app. It must be open. The retouch filter can make a lot of changes. Here's before and here's the after. Oh my god, I look like a different person. You can make your skin softer, you can change the skin tone. Okay, it's a bit more natural. It still isn't me, you know that. You can do a lot of things, change your eye size, cheekbone. For example, if I do this, wow. It's also changing my voice, you see. I can't speak like before. I'm just kidding. You can change your nose. I want my nose to be the way it is. I mean, your mouth, voice and your teeth, you see. Maybe this value is good. I mean, my teeth is already white. That's why it doesn't look natural. It does a pretty well job at following your face. I don't see any problems. Let's try man. Yeah, this still follows my face very well. You can change the way your body looks. I mean, it took a lot of time to build this body. I'm not gonna change it, you know. You can do makeup, for example, lipstick. We have also blushes. Let me see how I look. I look cute. I don't want that. I want to be handsome, you know. We have some other makeup settings such as dodge and burn, and but you decide what you want. You have a lot of options to go through, but I'd rather to have it off because I like the way I look without any retouch and filters, and it makes me me. It's just me though. In the filters tab, you can choose different filters. Wow, you can also change the level. Here's how to use them on OBS. First, turn on the preview on the app. Then in OBS, when selecting the device, choose OBSBOT Virtual Camera. Then you need to enable it by this option in OBSBOT Center. Now, whatever filter or retouch or bokeh you apply here will be affected on OBS and other apps as well. But keep in mind, this way you can't select 24 FPS. You'll be limited to the default resolution and frame rates in OBS Center, which is okay. You may wonder, is it compatible with Nvidia Broadcast? Yes, it is. And you can also use multiple effects in Nvidia Broadcast. Background removal, I can use it simultaneously with all those AI features. You can also use other effects such as eye contact. You can see right now I'm not looking at the camera for real. It's eye contact in Nvidia Broadcast makes me look like I'm looking at the webcam. But in reality, this is where I am looking. It supports full 4K quality, at least on my RTX 3070 with vignette, video, noise removal. Even auto frame, we have auto frame in Nvidia Broadcast as well, but both of these work fine. We also have an audio mixer in the video preview app. Here you can choose another microphone source as the webcam mic, so it'll be the default on your streaming app. You can mute, unmute, and also mix different tracks if you want to. Let's say you want your game audio and mic to pass through the same source. There are multiple options. You can also monitor the audio on a device to hear your voice and check it before streaming or video calls. Who is this webcam for? In my opinion, it's great for gamers, streamers, video calls with your friends, online classes, video conferences, or even recording videos for YouTube. However, lighting is everything. Without good lighting, even a $10,000 camera doesn't look very good. And with a little tweaking, if you know how to use it, you can get the best results. There are a few other exclusive features that I didn't talk about, which I like to mention here. If you record with 1x zoom and later crop it, the quality wouldn't be as good as using the in-app feature. Why? Because even on a digital zoom, the AI makes the details much better. This is a very good comparison between my cropped version in editing versus the zoom on the camera software. The raw details are really high and you can get a near flat level of quality. For example, if I reduce the color to around 38 or 40, and if I reduce the contrast to something like 0, this looks a little flat, but I can color grade it in my software later like this to get any looks I like. You can manually change the focus and lock it there if you want to. There's an exposure compensation if you're gonna use the automatic exposure. It's like an adjustment over the overall brightness of the scene. So if I set it to zero, you can see in my case, because the background is very dark, it's gonna make the overall picture too bright. So you can reduce it up to -3, which is a great range, or increase it to +3 to make everything brighter. Regardless of that automatic adjustment, let's say I turn off the lights and it still does the job. It automatically changes the brightness, you see? However, again, in my opinion, if you can learn about how shutter speed works and ISO, so you can get the best results. But at last, we have the price, pros and cons. The price tag is $129. What do you think? In my opinion, for the quality this webcam provides and the options it has, the price is very good. We talked about a lot of pros, big sensor, high quality 4K picture and AI features. But there is one con I found for this webcam, and that was the included Type-C cable. While recording videos and testing it, I realized if I move it a lot or stretch it, it will disconnect, not unplugging from the port, but actually not working properly. Once I used my own USB 3 cable, the issue was fixed and there was no other problems. So maybe the cable that comes with this webcam is not built very good, but aside from that, everything else is great. Let me know if you have any questions and I'll catch you in the next one.